f we are continuous on closed interval a to b, then there exists a point c such that f of c equal to a to b f of x dx. What do you mean by that? That means कोई भी एक इंटीग्रेशन है, इसमें एक पॉइंट तो ऐसा कहीं पे तो आएगा सच दैट अगर मैंने उसके अंडर वी फाइंड द एरिया, सो दैट विल गिव मी द सेम जो भी ये एरिया था, दैट इज जो पूरा ये पार्ट था, जो ये पार्ट है दैट विल बी हियर, जो एक्स्ट्रा पार्ट है वो इधर कवर हो जाएगा एंड दैट विल जस्ट वी आर मेकिंग इट यू नो अ रेक्टेंगल, जितना भी ये सब है इसको कट पिट करके वी आर जस्ट मेकिंग इट लाइक यू आर फिलिंग दिस gap and making it a rectangular form or square form, whatever it may be. Is that okay? Yeah. So let me give one more thing. That is called first mean value theorem. Or ek aayega. Ye ho gaya mean value theorem. Next is weighted or first. ये सब का प्रूफ इतना मतलब है नहीं उनके सिलेबस के लिए. लेट एफ कॉमा जी बी कंटिन्यूस ऑन ए बी, अज्यूम दैट जी डज नॉट चेंज sign on AB, then for some C belong to AB we have this integration of A to B f of x gx dx that is equal to f of c into integration of a to b g of x dx. Okay, yeah, so this is what you have to prove now. Do you understand this? This is product of two function, f of x into g of x, and this is we are approximating f of x as f of c, and this is integration a to b g of x dx. So we need to find existence of c. That is, there is for some c, this is true. Okay. Do you see why we require this part? G does not change the sign on AB. Maybe I will ask the same question again after proving this. Correct? Okay. So without loss of generality. Without loss of generality means what? Means what? You are having the option G does not change the sign on AB. That means what? In the interval AB, either G is positive or G is negative. Is that okay? So suppose without loss of generality, suppose I am taking G is always positive. Correct? So I am assuming this in my proof, I will be assuming the same thing. I won't be going that G is negative somewhere, correct? So that my proof, that's why we say without loss of generality. Assume that G is positive, and let M equal to infimum of F and capital M equal to supremum of F. So you already know if you have infimum and supremum, then you know f is less than f of x is less than equal to capital M. Is that okay? And since g is positive, if I multiply in this, then it will be m into g of x that is less than equal to f of x into g of x that is less than equal to capital M into g of x. Is that okay, everyone? Is that okay? Abhi tak kuch nahi kiya. Just without loss of generality, we assume that g is greater than equal to 0. Why this is required? Because we are having an option. Either g is positive or g is negative. So that's why it is better to choose one of the case. Suppose g is positive. Even I should not take 0 also. Let me just make it strictly positive. No, your it is better. It is okay. It is okay if it is like this. Yeah, that's okay. So your g is positive, m is infimum, capital M is supremum, and this is true, then this is true. Can I take integration both the side? Why this is true? Why can I do that? Because we have already proved monotonicity of integral. Monotonicity means what? If f is less than g, then integration of f, that will be less than integration of g. Is that okay? So if I take integration, this will become small m integration e to b g of x dx, that is less than equal to integration e to b f of x into g of x dx, and that is less than equal to capital M integration e to b g of x dx. Is that okay? Yes. Now, since we have assumed g of x is greater than equal to 0, if g of x equal to 0, then what? Integration of a to b g of x will be also 0, then there is nothing to prove. Do you see that? Ye bhi 0, ye bhi 0, toh ye pura term hi 0 aa jayega. Yeah? Correct? So next case is, let us consider, suppose g is positive. If g is positive, that means what? Integration of a to b g of x, it will be positive. Correct? If it is positive, can I divide this thing, whole thing, by g of x, integration g of x? If we are having a positive number, then we can divide it. So this side, it will be small m, that is less than equal to integration e to b f of x into g of x dx, divided by integration e to b g of x dx, that is less than equal to capital M. Yes, is that okay? Now, do you remember that mean value theorem? What was that mean value theorem? Sorry, intermediate value theorem. What do you mean by intermediate value theorem? If your function is taking some value between m to m, since your function is continuous, so can I say that there exists c belong to AB such that this part equal to c, this part will be actually f of c, because what is small m and capital M? See, I'm not taking intermediate value theorem on this. I am taking intermediate value theorem on function f of x, and we know that function f of x, it is continuous on that closed interval a to b, and this small m and capital M is infimum and supremum. Do you see that? Infimum of f, supremum of f. Is that okay? So if there is in between any value, so there will be a c such that f of c will be that value, that is a to b f of x gx dx upon e to b g of x dx. Is that okay, everyone? Do you see the proof? Do you see? Now we just need to make this part there. You will get the proof. Let us see once again. What we have to prove: integration e to b f of x gx dx, that is equal to f of c integration e to b g of x dx. Okay, so you see that without loss of generality, assume that suppose g is positive greater than equal to 0, and you are assuming small m is infimum, capital M is supremum. So small m is less than equal to f of x, that is less than equal to capital M, multiplying by g of x, this is this. Next, taking integration, this is okay, correct? So, because why am I doing this? Because observe this, from here f of c will be something upon integration a to b g of x. Correct? So, I just want to use that part only. So, here I am having. Now, if g of x is 0, then there is nothing to prove, because ye bhi 0, ye bhi 0, toh ye pura term hi 0 ho jayega. Correct? So, there is nothing to prove. but if g of x is positive, then integration a to gx, that is also positive, so I can divide that. So if I divide, then this will be small m, that is less than equal to a to b f of x gx upon a divided by m. Now observe that, what did your intermediate value theorem, can you state intermediate value theorem, can somebody, just main iska answer likh deta hu. Can you just give me the whole statement? I just want to put. Correct, this is the thing, hence proved. Can somebody just give me the statement of intermediate value theorem? There are two parts of intermediate value theorem we have proved. Yes, anyone? Tell me. Let me just make the graph. Suppose when I make like this, that will be not the general case. Yeah, in that only both will work. Yeah. Can you give me the statement, everyone? Or should I ask with someone? Payal, can you tell me what is the statement? So this is it. Is continuous. One more condition is there, that is f of a that is less than some k, I think, and that is, or lambda, whatever I have used, I think lambda in the proof, that is less than equal to f of b, then there will be a c in between the interval a to b such that f of c equal to k. Zero kab rahega ye? जब इन बिटवीन जीरो रहेगा, मतलब इन बिटवीन जीरो का मतलब क्या, मतलब दोनों का प्रोडक्ट अगर लिया मैंने तो दैट इज नेगेटिव, दैट इज नेगेटिव, मतलब एफ ऑफ ए एंड एफ ऑफ बी टेक्स अपोजिट साइन. व्हाट डू मीन बाय इट टेक्स अपोजिट साइन? डू सी, अगर मैंने ए टू बी में देखा तो यहाँ से लेके यहाँ तक दिस इज नेगेटिव साइन, दिस इज पॉजिटिव साइन, सो देयर विल बी सम पॉइंट जिस पे मेरा फंक्शन जीरो आ रहा है. देख रहे हैं कौन सा पॉइंट? There will be a point जिस पे मेरा function zero आ रहा है. In general case में क्या बोलता है ये, अगर कोई भी function है यहाँ से यहाँ तक, so अगर बीच में कोई भी value लिया मैंने तो उसके लिए एक c exist करेगा जो ये interval के बीच में ही रहेगा, like that. Is that clear? This is a to b. If I take any value between this, this is f of a, this is f of b. If I take any value, so I will be having a c. Why this is possible? Since your function is continuous, that's why. There will be a c such that f of c equal to k. That is that okay? Now my question is this: why we require g does not change the sign on a b? What will be the problem if this happens? If g change the sign on a b, then what will be the issue? What will be the issue? Perfect, very nice. Yes. So at some point g will be zero, then we won't able to get this. We won't able to divide that. But one more thing, I have proved the theorem for g is positive. I have assumed without loss of generality g is greater than equal to 0. What will be the proof of g is less than 0? Can I use the same proof? What, how, if g is less than equal to 0, then I can define h which is equal to minus g, and h is greater than equal to 0. सो आई विल यूज़ द सेम थ्योरम जो ऊपर मैंने यूज़ किया है विथ एच. डू यू सी, फिर एच की जगह पे माइनस जी रख देने का, इधर माइनस जी दोनों कैंसिल हो जाएंगे एंड यू विल गेट द प्रूफ. इज इट क्लियर एवरीवन क्या किया मैंने? वी हैव प्रूव्ड अ थ्योरम फॉर पॉजिटिव नंबर, नाउ वी वॉन्ट टू प्रूव इट फॉर नेगेटिव नंबर. सो वॉट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम जस्ट पुटिंग दैट नेगेटिव, दैट इज नेगेटिव, जी इज नेगेटिव, सो हाउ कैन आई मेक इट पॉजिटिव? मल्टीप्लाई विथ माइनस. सो आई एम डिफाइनिंग न्यू फंक्शन एच एज माइनस ऑफ जी. सो वॉट अबाउट दिस एच? दिस विल सेटिस्फाई द अबव थ्योरम वॉट एवर वी हैव जस्ट प्रूव्ड, करेक्ट? गुड, इज दैट ओके एवरीवन? There are so many actually mean value theorem, so I will just not go in that part. Correct? You can see that, or should I state? Let me just state it. You just see the proof. Proof are quite simple here. Second mean value theorem, that state as let G be continuous on AB and FB continuously differentiable on AB. Further assume F dash does not change sign. Here F dash does not change sign on AB. You must understand कि ये change sign का मतलब क्या होता है, क्या problem आएगा अगर change होएगा तो. Then there exists C belong to AB such that indication A to B F of X G of X dx that will be equal to F of A indication A to C g of x dx plus f of b indication C to b g of x dx, correct? This is A to C, this is C to b. This is what your second mean value theorem. So tum log ko first mean value theorem ke jaisa dikh raha hai ye. When will be this first mean value theorem? सी यहाँ पे क्या किया, ए टू सी मैंने डिफाइन किया और सी टू बी. अगर ये लिमिट मेरा सेम होता तो दिस टू विल बी सेम ओनली, और वो मेरा समथिंग टू एफ ऑफ ए आता है ये केस में, या टू दैट इज एफ ऑफ सी हम लोग बोलते हैं, कुछ और पॉइंट रहता वो. या सो इसमें कैन यू सी समथिंग, दिस इज यूजिंग सम इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स, समथिंग लुकिंग लाइक इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स. Do you see that? Hello. If you see the proof also, that is quite simple. Correct? We will be using your first mean value theorem. That is, what is your first mean value theorem? This. If you have indication E to B, F of X, EX, DX, then we can write it as there will be a C such that F of C A to B G of X dx. But here the condition on G is G does not change the sign. So what do you think here the condition is given as? F dash does not change the sign. So from here the one thing is clear to you, that is you need to assume something. Should I start the proof? Let me just do that quickly. Let us do that for the proof. Let g of x equal to define karta hume, that is a to x g of x dx. What is this? Isko hum log kya bolte hai? Indefinite integral, isn't it? Correct? Yaad hai ki nahi? Fundamental theorem, second fundamental theorem. of calculus. Let me ask you a question. If g of x is continuous, what can you say about capital G of x? Yes. Anyone? Perfect. It is differentiable. Do you agree, everyone? Good. Actually, integration क्या करता है उसको? एक step ऊपर भेजता है. So ये continuous है, तो इससे बड़ा कौन था ना? Differentiable. So g of x is differentiable. Good. And what will be the derivative of g of x? G dash will be g of x. Correct? That is g dash of x will be g of x. That's okay. So can I use integration by part? That is integration e to b f of x g of x dx. What is integration by part? That is g of x kya hai tumhara? You must write a to b. What is f of x? What is your g of x here? It is g dash of x. You see, apply integration by parts on this. So if you apply, kya milega tumko? First limit kya aega? F integration of g. That is, yeah. Can you see what is g of a? First value kya aega ye? F of x into g of x. Capital G hai, ye small f hai. Between a to b. Is that okay? This is first part. So और कुछ आएगा, let us keep it aside. पहले ये part क्या आएगा देखो, put b, put a. If you put lower limit b here, this will be f of b, g of b. And if you put lower limit a, then what? This will be f of a and g of a. Observe that capital G मैंने define कैसे किया, a to x. अगर मैंने g of a निकाला तो वो क्या आएगा? Yes, what will be my g of a? Hello. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, everyone? What will be capital G of A? That is my question. अरे तुम लोग बोलते भी नहीं हो भाई. कैपिटल जी ऑफ ए इट विल बी जीरो ना, बिकॉज बोथ योर लिमिट इज ए ओनली. दिस इज ए, दिस इज ऑल्सो ए, सो इट विल बी जीरो. करेक्ट? दैट इज ओके. एंड वट इज द नेक्स्ट पार्ट क्या आएगा? इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स देखो. दिस विल बी ए टू बी. ये क्या होता है? एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स इंटू ये जी ऑफ एक्स हो जाएगा सिर्फ. एंड दिस इज डी एक्स. करेक्ट? तो ये क्या आएगा? ये टर्म आएगा तुम्हारा एफ ऑफ बी इंटू जी ऑफ बी. एंड दिस इज माइनस इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स जी ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स. ओके, नाउ कैन आई अप्लाई द फर्स्ट फंडामेंटल थ्योरम ऑन दिस? कैन आई डू दैट बाय, सॉरी, फर्स्ट मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम. फर्स्ट मीन value theorem. Since for first mean value theorem, what is the condition required? That is one of the function it must not take. See, g does not change the sign on ab. F into g hai, to isme se g does not change the sign hona chahiye. To idhar kaun hai aisa? Ye case mein, do you see? Ye case mein this is working as a g. Because this does not change sign, so if we apply, then you will get a to b. Let me write as g of x into f dash of x. X. Apply that first mean value theorem. This does not change the sign, so answer kya aayega? Answer kya aayega?
that is capital G. No, sorry, this is capital G. This is capital G. Here also this is capital G of x, f of x. So ये क्या आएगा, ये g of c, first fundamental theorem, integration e to b f dash of x dx. What is integration e to b f dash of x dx? That you already know, that is g of c into f of b minus f of a. Integration derivative ना cancel, so just limit बचेगा. So can we substitute this part here and you will get your answer. Just see, your left hand side is integration e to b f of x gx dx and right hand side is f of b g of b. What is your g of b? F of b g of c. And what is this? Now I am just substituting this part as this. Do you see that? This. So you will be having this f of b g of b minus this part, that is g of c into f of b minus f of a. Correct? What else? Can I do something? Can I write this as f of a into g of c plus f of b into g of b minus g of a? Why am I writing like this? Because proof में मेरे को क्या चाहिए, ये f of a होना चाहिए, ये f of b होना चाहिए, ऐसा कुछ. Can you see in the proof? We require this f of a, this is f of b. Now observe that ये यही है क्या, a to c. This is g of c. So capital G of c क्या है? That is a to c. Yes, यही है. And what about this? G of b minus g of a क्या रहेगा? Sorry, g of b minus g of c आएगा ना ये? g of b minus g of c क्या आएगा? G of b means what? This is a to b. G of c means what? A to c. But g of c minus में है. So do you see, वो c to b आएगा minus को exchange करने का, and just accordingly. Is that clear everyone? Let me just repeat it once again. Yeah, in the second mean value theorem, the statement is g is continuous and f is continuously differentiable on this. Further assume that f dash does not change the sign. So here the condition is f dash does not change the sign. So we need to prove there exists a c such that this is true. So what we started with, g of x equal to a to x gx dx. Next, if g of x is continuous, then capital G of x is differentiable. Differential and उसका derivative क्या आएगा, g of x मैं लिख देता हूँ, और integration e to b f of x g of x dx बोला, correct? So what is that integration? Your g of x is g dash of x. फिर यहाँ पे integration by parts use किया, first part देखा f of b g of b minus f of a g of a आएगा, but g of a is zero, so that's it. वो गया, तो यही आया, and ये part मैंने ऐसे रखा, correct? फिर ये पार्ट में मैंने फर्स्ट मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम अप्लाई किया. व्हाई कैन आई अप्लाई दैट? बिकॉज इन दिस पार्ट जो ये फंक्शन है, दैट डजंट चेंज द साइन. सो दिस इज वर्किंग एज जी, अपना पिछले थ्योरम के जी के जैसा है वो. सो आई एम राइटिंग इट एज जी ऑफ एक्स एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स. डू यू सी दैट? फर्स्ट मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम में देखो, यही है ना, एफ ऑफ एक्स इंटू जी ऑफ एक्स था, वेयर योर जी डज नॉट चेंज द साइन. सो आंसर क्या था? एफ ऑफ सी इंटू ए टू बी. सो हियर ऑल्सो आई विल गेट अ सी. Here also, if this is true, so there exists a C. I should write there exists a C belong to AB such that this A to B G of X F dash of X, it will be G of C A to B F dash of X dx. Correct? So what is F dash of A to B? That is F of B minus F of A ho gaya. And what about this? Just substitute kar do isme. Ye jo bhi hum log ne nikala hai, isme substitute kar do. You will get that. ये पार्ट मिला एफ ऑफ ए इंटू जी ऑफ सी, ये पार्ट मिला एफ ऑफ बी इंटू ए का सब्ट्रैक्शन. सो सब्ट्रैक्शन को सॉल्व करोगे, इफ यू वांट लेट मी डू दैट. सो व्हाट इज दिस? एफ ऑफ ए इंटू जी ऑफ सी मीन्स व्हाट? ए टू सी एफ ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स, और व्हाट? या जी ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स. एंड नेक्स्ट पार्ट विल बी प्लस एफ ऑफ बी, दिस इज इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी जी ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स माइनस दिस इज अगेन ए टू सी जी ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स. डू यू सी दैट एवरी वन?
या
एफ ऑफ बी मीन्स वॉट ए टू बी, जी ऑफ सी मीन्स वॉट, सॉरी जी ऑफ बी मीन्स वॉट ए टू बी एंड जी ऑफ सी मीन्स वॉट ए टू सी. सो जस्ट माइनस साइन हो तो ये उल्टा होएगा, सी टू ए होएगा. या नहीं, आई थिंक हाँ सी टू ए होएगा. देन वॉट डू सी दैट दिस विल बी ए टू सी, सॉरी सी टू ए एंड हियर ए टू बी. सो फाइनल कैन आई राइट इट लाइक दिस? This will become, yes, what will be that? Can you see that? That will be C2B, good. Because C2A and A2B, so this is C2B G of X dx. This was proved, this was to prove, hence proved. Correct? Yes, is that okay? Okay, actually let me write this second mean value theorem one. और एक और है वो, जस्ट मैं स्टेटमेंट देखता हूँ, यू जस्ट ट्राई. बाई यूजिंग दिस ओनली यू कैन डू दैट. सेकेंड मेन वैल्यू थ्योरम टू. तो मोस्टली कितने मीन हो गए? पहले तो मैंने मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम बोला, फिर बोला फर्स्ट मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम बोला, फिर सेकेंड मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम वन, सेकेंड मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम टू. ये क्या है? इफ फंक्शन ए टू बी टू आर बी मोनोटोन देन देयर एग्जिस्ट सी बिलोंग टू ए टू बी सच दैट इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी एफ ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स दैट विल बी इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ ए इंटू सी माइनस ए. Yeah, that is quite easy. You just try with this. Plus f of b into b minus c. Graphically bhi dekha to ye tumko samjhega. Let me just give you a hint. Iska proof tum log try karna. Let me just give you a hint. What do you mean by this? So suppose integration, suppose let me make it like that. Suppose this is a and this is suppose b, correct? तो क्वेश्चन में क्या बोलता है, एक ऐसा c बीच में आना चाहिए such that, so suppose मैं यहाँ पे c लिया चलेगा, यहाँ पे मैंने एक point c लिया, तो क्या आना चाहिए f of a into c minus a, f of b into b minus c, correct? What do you mean by that? मतलब f of a into c minus a, मतलब ये केस के लिए सिर्फ इतना मैंने लिया f of a, this point will be f of a. सो जो एक्स्ट्रा ग्राफ में कवर हुआ या एक्स्ट्रा आएगा दैट विल बी दिस पार्ट फॉर दिस एंड दिस विल बी सी टू बी. सी टू बी में क्या आएगा? एफ ऑफ बी कंसिडर करूँगा ये, करेक्ट? सो इधर जो बच रहा है वो इधर मतलब फिक्स होगा. मतलब ये केस में भी वी आर मेकिंग इट स्ट्रेट, बट स्ट्रेट दो फॉर्म में कर रहे हैं, ए टू सी में और सी टू बी में, ऐसा, करेक्ट? विल यू ट्राई दिस वन? अभी जस्ट एक थ्योरम प्रूफ किया, यू यूज वॉट एवर वी हैव प्रूव्ड. ओ सॉरी, आई थिंक ग्राफ मेरा गलत हुआ, क्योंकि वो लोग ने एक कंडीशन दिया था. डू यू सी फर्स्ट कंडीशन क्या था? डू यू सी एवरीवन? फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज योर फंक्शन शुड बी मोनोटोन. सो लेट मी ड्रॉ लाइक दिस. सो अभी ये हो गया ए, ये हो गया बी. दिस शुड बी द ग्राफ ए बी. इन बिटवीन देयर विल बी अ सी सच दैट क्या करना है अपने को? फर्स्ट ए टू सी के लिए मेरे को एक बनाना है ग्राफ. सो दिस विल बी माय शेडेड एरिया. दिस इज पॉइंट एफ ऑफ ए, करेक्ट? डू यू सी दैट एफ ऑफ ए इंटू सी माइनस ए ये पार्ट आएगा एंड वॉट विल बी एफ ऑफ बी? एफ ऑफ बी क्या आएगा? ये पार्ट आएगा. दिस इज माई शेडेड एरिया नाउ. डू यू सी, सो देयर विल एग्जिस्ट अ सी, मतलब कर क्या रहे, जो ये एक्स्ट्रा पार्ट आ रहा है ना, जो एक्स्ट्रा पार्ट इधर का बच रहा है उसको मैं इधर शिफ्ट कर रहा हूँ ऐसा, टू मेक इट एज अ रेक्टेंगुलर फॉर्म. हियर वी आर मेकिंग इट एज टू रेक्टेंगुलर फॉर्म. इज इट क्लियर? ओके देन आई थिंक आई शुड स्टॉप नाउ.